startup times for App Engine Java are pretty high for my application, around 30 seconds. And that is actually pretty high. And Java apps in general, even with reserved instances that we feel are underutilized, we're still getting warm-up requests. Any advice?
Yeah, so I think, again, this is going to be something that's going to be covered quite extensively in Google I.O. We have a talk. Matt Stevenson is going to be giving a talk on auto-scaling Java. Yeah. So that talk is likely to cover much of that. And Matt Stevenson also, with one of our other guys from Cloud Solutions, Wally Yao, he wrote an article that's published on the App Engine developers documentation site for managing optimization of starting up Spring applications. And often we find that it's Spring applications that really take the longest time to start. There's a lot of libraries involved. There's a lot of scanning of classes and such like that goes on automatically with Spring when it starts up. And that can lead to quite long load times. I think, as I suspect, this is probably likely to be a Spring issue. At the same time, I mean, there's also the possibility that you're loading libraries that you may not need immediately, and you may want to actually look at lazy loading those,
yep.
Loading them in the background as opposed to actually loading them as your instance starts. Anything you can do to minimize the amount of time it takes to start the application is good. And really, I think that's the key to handling things like startup requests, things that will cause a new instance to start, is basically just to minimize the time it takes to load your application initially. Only load what you need, lazy load everything. Don't load things you don't need to load, and also make sure if you're using Spring that you follow the advice in the Google I/O token and in that particular document on the website. That will minimize your startup times, and you won't be so worried about startup requests and things that actually load a new instance, because they won't take so long to do.
Yep, all very good advice. So yeah, definitely check out the Google I/O talk. All the talks at I/O are going to be recorded, so we can check those out. Talks happening next week,
yep.
So it's a great resource.
That's on Wednesday, by the way. So are they live streamed?
Some of the talks are.
Some of the talks are live streamed, yep. Yeah.
Okay. I'm not sure if Matt's talk is live streamed, okay. But you'll be able to catch it pretty soon. Yep. Maybe something to just say a little bit more general about App Engine Java, especially these Spring apps or applications that have these big frameworks and long loading times. So one way to think about this is the way that we've been building application servers for many years has been in an environment where you would spin up, say five application servers, and these would be big servers that would sit on a rack somewhere, and they would take several minutes to kind of boot up, do all the memory checks, right? Machine would load up, it would load the application server software, then it would load the specific applications. And that whole process could take 10, 20 minutes sometimes. Yep. But then those servers, they would run for weeks or months or however long they needed to run. And in that environment, what you actually want to do is kind of do all the expensive work up front when you're loading the application, because you know you're only going to do that one time, and then you're going to have long-lived servers.
Yep.
App Engine tries to really kind of fundamentally deal with applications in a different way. When we want to scale up very quickly to handle an increase in traffic to your website, or when we want to scale down because there's a little bit less traffic coming in, we really need the ability to quickly spin up new instances of your application and then spin them back down kind of at a moment's notice. And so App Engine is kind of optimized around apps that have a very short startup time. Ideally, it's hundreds of milliseconds. Maybe it's a few seconds on the outset. When you start getting into like the 30-second time frame, that's really a whole different ballpark. Now, if that's something you want to do and you want to run Spring applications and you say, I get a lot of benefit out of that, and why can't I just run an App Engine? You can. We actually, I think a year ago or so, we introduced some extra knobs on the admin console specifically for these users. What you'll need to do is go into the admin console, make sure you enable billing, because that exposes all the knobs that we have.
Right.
And then go into your application settings. And there's a couple of settings around min-max idle instances, min-max pending requests, latency.
Yeah.
And those allow you to kind of tune the cost performance of your application. So if you know you have long loading requests and you just need to keep in a few extra instances around to make sure you can handle those spikes, even though you have long instances, you can actually crank up the min idle instances.
Right, okay.
On the other hand, if you know, if you're a fast starting app and you're very cost sensitive, there's ways to tune it kind of the other direction. We recommend everyone start out with the automatic settings, but we do have some special knobs for that, and I'm sure Matt in his talk will go into a lot more detail than we did right here.
Yeah, definitely.
Specifically around Java applications. So that's definitely something we care about, and we'll have some advice for you.
Yeah, that's great.